Hello, my name is Nancy Hulse, and I will be your host for this program. For over 20 years, I've devoted my life to ending violence against women. 10 years ago, I developed what I believe to be a unique way to educate about the issues of domestic violence and sexual assault. Combining my personal experience working with abused women, along with my passion for music, poetry, and theater, I created multimedia educational programs dealing with these issues. Since then, I have performed these shows hundreds of times all across the United States. The music and dance engages the audience while I fulfilled my basic goal, which is to educate both men and women about the realities of violence against women. Throughout my years of traveling and performing, I have met many people. I've met countless survivors of domestic violence and rape. Women whose stories of abuse and society's inability to provide support are tragically similar. I have also met friends and family members of victims, along with other people who struggle with the same basic questions, the same basic myths about the nature of a violent relationship. Although considerable effort has been made by many advocates over the years to educate people and change laws, violence in the home continues at an alarming rate. 10 women will die today in the United States at the hands of their batterers. Only through education, advocacy, and continued efforts to raise awareness can we hope to find a solution to this crippling social epidemic. This video is meant to provide answers to the most basic questions about an abusive relationship. What is abuse? How does it happen? Who is the victim, and who is the abuser? Only when we understand the basics and dispel the myths can we answer the greatest question of all: how do we stop it? I want to tell you about this guy I met. He's so good to me, he worships the ground I walk on. I never had anyone treat me the way he does. What is domestic violence? Does an occasional push, shove, slap, or hit mean I'm in an abusive relationship? What about verbal insults or extreme jealousy? What if you are cut off from family and friends or not allowed by your partner to make the simplest decision without getting permission? What if you are forced or made to feel obligated to have sex when you don't want to? And what if those things only happen once in a while? It has to happen all the time to be an abusive relationship, right? If you have to ask yourself if you are in an abusive relationship, then most likely you are in one. Any relationship that includes violence and/or threats of violence by one partner towards another is an abusive relationship. All abusive relationships contain abusers who use similar methods to reach a common goal: to gain and keep power and control over their victims. First, let's define the different types of abuse. Physical abuse. Punching, hitting, slapping, choking, biting, and kicking are obvious signs of an abusive relationship, and this kind of abuse is very common. Hospital emergency rooms are teeming with victims who suffer injuries ranging from a black eye to broken bones and serious internal damage. Abuse is the leading cause of injury to women between the ages of 15 to 44. And abuse is also one of the leading causes of miscarriages and birth defects due to battering during pregnancy. Physical abuse is not always apparent from the outside either. Many batterers purposely strike their victims in places from the neck down that are covered by clothing and thus invisible to the outside world. Many victims who suffer bruises and other injuries are often embarrassed and use methods such as makeup or other clothing to hide the signs. Victims who suffer more serious injuries sometimes simply hide until the wounds heal. Do you have a coworker who misses a lot of work due to unexplained illness? Domestic violence can sometimes be the problem. It is estimated that $100 million a year is lost to businesses because of domestic violence. Physical violence is not always the only or first method that is used to control the victim. There are other ways that abusers can hurt you, both physically and mentally. Emotional and psychological abuse, making you feel crazy, constantly putting you down, attacking your self-esteem until you feel worthless, are abusive behaviors that can be just as damaging as a punch or slap. Remember, if your partner wishes to control you, one of the best ways to do so is to make you feel that you don't deserve anything better. As long as you can be made to feel dependent and worthless, you will be unable to stand up for yourself. By the time the abuser gets around to actually hitting you, you will probably figure it was your fault anyway. Counselors who have worked for years with battered women have said that while most physical wounds heal after a short period of time, the mental and emotional scars stay with them for the rest of their lives. Another component of emotional and psychological abuse is verbal abuse. Name-calling, demeaning references to you, like you're stupid, you're lazy, you're a bitch or a whore. Threats of violence to you, your children, your family, and friends. These are all behaviors that are designed to destroy your self-esteem and create obstacles that prevent you from leaving or seeking help. Threats of violence against your children are as serious as the act of hitting itself, and many women are forced to endure long-term abuse because of these threats. Threats to your family and friends are designed to deny you emotional support and help, to isolate you totally inside the abuser's world, and make you afraid to tell anyone about your situation. Remember also that these threats are not just threats. They are warnings of real physical violence to come. Domestic violence left unchallenged and unnoticed is a threat to all of us. Friends and family members are often killed when an abusive relationship explodes into extreme violence. Domestic violence is a leading cause of homicide in the workplace, and domestic violence calls are some of the most dangerous calls a police officer can answer. Sometimes the abuser will use a kind of reverse psychology when threatening violence. I will kill myself if you leave. This attempts to put all the responsibility for the abusive relationship on you, playing on your love and sense of obligation.